sneak on through, but it's the axe to deal with the dazzle. And I believe that was happening in just a game a little while ago as well. We've seen some folks picking up dazzles to deal, keeping their team alive, and axe, totally viable.
Axe sometimes is good versus the... people have a misconception of Axe versus Dazzle. I think Dazzle counters Axe pretty effectively in the early game stage, where he tries to go for these plays with creep skipping or something along the lines, and this huge heal bomb comes out on the Axe, and then all of a sudden he's missing like half of his life, and then he just dies. So he can't play too aggressive. In the offlane, he might have to go to the Iron Talon effect here, but... in the later stages, as you're talking about, it does help versus a shallow grave. He can burst through that. And as long as he can get it up his levels, they can constantly run at people. Because that's what Team Secret love to do. They love to pick low cooldown ultimates or teamfight heroes like the Axe, like the Timbersaw, and just keep running at you. Whereas Escape, now they're kind of locked into this Faceless Void. Could be problematic if they miss it. But Kezu... he's a great player on this. So, I mean, we'll have to find out if it's going to pay off.
Should be good for weave setups. Could be good for arguably magnetized setups. See what they decide to pair with it. Tide comes out from Team Secret, another one of your favorite heroes that you like seeing here. And for Escape, obviously, there's still a Tinker, still an Invoker in the pool. Both of those, you can do some work with the Faceless Void. If you go the Exhort. Invoker, but do you think there's something here in particular that Escape want?
I just have to go Tinker now. It's either Tinker or DP, I think. I think you want to pick your mid for Escape now. Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, something that Koikba is very comfortable with. And talking about Faceless Void, do have some already a good amount of minus armor, since you should be able to get the weave on who's in that chronosphere. What are you liking here as a hard carry for Escape to use to poke into that chronosphere?
Yeah, both need a hard carry for the last one. Puppy's going to be handling the axe, so... 5 seconds remaining. I'm trying to think right now, like, at the same time, I'm trying to think of both, like, what they really both want. That's good. I think... Weaver or Ursa is pretty good for Escape, even though it might not synergize well with the Faceless Void. I think Ursa is still one of those heroes that can blow up Timbersaw. And Weaver is one of those heroes that can sit on the outside looking in. But the Axe is kind of like the X Factor. Axe versus Weaver. You get called, you're pretty much dead. Whereas with Ursa, you still have that Enrage to work with.
It feels like a lot of the options that can poke into the chronosphere, like the Weaver, like the Klinx, really suffer from being caught by Axe, or blown up immediately by Timbersaw, right? You get called by that Axe, Timbersaw will kill you in that duration if he's around, so.
Yeah, I just like the Ursa here a lot from Escape, because you can punish the Tide in the offlane, and you can try and go for that early Roche. And try to get more map control around. 5 seconds. Nothing else is really screaming at me right now. I mean, if they want to get really cute, I don't know about that. This thing about Dusa, though. That Dusa, though.
Yeah, the Spectre ban was an.
It's good Spectre ban, because you don't want to have a Spectre haunting constantly on top of you.
Escape just trying to make sure that their Tinker is nice and safe. As you said. Gaming, they actually have a nice amount of reserve time, Puppy being the one who was dipping really low, trying to figure his shit out.
I guess they're thinking probably now, do they want to go Klinx, or do they want to go Ursa? I do think that's what Escape are trying to go for their last core, and then Team Secret, they can still go Eternal Envy, Klinx themselves. Really good here, because you can set up a lot of ganks and try to find out the Tinker. Not really sure what else. I guess Ember Spirit, decent game. Yeah, I think Ember Spirit for Team Secret. Escape is Klinx or Ursa.
Yeah, I'm actually looking over some of the other matchups that are happening right now, because I believe that we have a few more that will really help settle down or break down the group and how it's going to go.
Ooh.
And
I thought Eternal Envy might go that earlier, but... very interesting. Very interesting pick. It's like very greedy. And it's all about that late game right now. Or escape.
How are they going to get enough farm for... You know, Tinka's going to be taking a lot out. Morphling needs a lot. And Faceless Void wants some.
This is literally a 60, 70 minute game that Escape really want to do right now.
Well, I'm going to drink the rest of this Red Bull. And it's AM.
There we go. Yeah, that Morphling kind of changed the dynamic of the pick there for the last one. And this is a good hero against the Tinker. And since they know that Escape is going to be playing very greedy this game, Anti-Mage is going to be able to be picked, and they don't have that many ways to punish him early on. So this is going to be an amazing Anti-Mage game. Going later into this game, they have the Faces Void, but Morphling head-to-head against the Anti-Mage later on, it's going to be like who can kill the other backliners first, more so. Anti-Mage... This looks like a really good game for Team Secret to win, but Escape Gaming prove us all wrong. They can have a really good early game, transition nice. I want to see this Morphling work out, but I'm not sold on it just yet because of the way that Team Secret have countered.
Yeah, I am going to be really interested to see how the landing phase breaks down. Obviously, a lot of people, I think, would expect Secret to be the stronger landing phase team. So Escape have a lot to prove here already. Yapso doing some deep warding, trying to make sure that they can spot out rotations coming out from Secret. And the good luck have funds are dropping. Let's do some quick player introductions. On Escape, we're going to be seeing Syndarin playing up that Dazzle, Tinka being played by Koikva, Morphling being played by Era, of course, very famously. He's not... Yeah, okay, I was going to say, I wasn't sure if he was wearing Morphling set or not. Earth Spirit being played by Yapzor, and finally Faceless Void being played up by Kazu. Tossing it over to you for Secret.
We've got Puppe playing that Axe. Going to be getting some booty this game. And then Pylite Die playing that Shadow Demon. Turn going to be playing Anti-Mage. Arteezy playing Timbersaw, what seems like the, I don't know, every single game this tournament. And then last but not least, Bulba. And on that Tidehunter, Watermelon.
Yeah, he's played a lot of Timbersaw, I believe, in the Open qualifiers. There was a day where all he played was Timbersaw. Don't quote me on that. Maybe it was just till the point where... some of us got to go to bed. Either way, let's get into it.
No such thing as sleeping at the hub.
Didn't actually last night, but... Well, Kazu, he's trying to be tricky here.
He didn't disrupt. I'm surprised they didn't even try to disrupt.
Well, that's because they have Shadow Poison first.
Okay.
This is going to be Pylidae harassing as much as he possibly can.
Yeah. I like the way they've set up for Escape, though. This ward mid and this ward in the jungle, scouting out where Puppy's gonna be farming. Scouting the rotations, not bad. Not bad at all.
Koikva up against Arteezy. You're gonna know more about not only these players and them smash up, how it should go. I'm trying to rack my brain for the last time I saw them face off.
Huh.
Right,
probably Team Tinker for Koifa and then EG for Arteezy. So, a good year and a half, maybe. Memory serves me right if they haven't played. Because Escape Gaming or No Diggity got eliminated at Epicenter.
Yep.
They didn't get the face off.
Exactly. So, who is winning this mid lane?
I think it's easier for Tinker to cause a lot of havoc and make Arteezy miss the last hits, but once Arteezy gets to level 3, he's going to be able to bully this Tinker out of the lane-ish. So it's going to come down to the runes a lot.
As Escape get to deal with that, we see Kazu taking a lot of damage in this bottom lane. Luckily, some of the creeps helping Kazu out, throwing a Hadouken at Puppy, but he's still taking a lot of that Shadow Poison. This is what's somewhat scary in the lane. Just a lot of damage output can be put onto Kazu pretty quickly.
Oh, mid dive in. They're going on Arteezy.
Yeah, they are going very aggressively. Koikva.
Oh, I missed.
Oh, no. They are going to instead lose the Earth Spirit. Arteezy getting that first blood, and that was not what Yapzo wanted to do there.
Nope, not at all.
so. Well, that is not a great start. Obviously, you never want your Earth Spirit feeding the opponent, but at least it wasn't the Tinker. Something.
Yeah, even if Quifa had landed his rocket, it wouldn't have killed him. So, but it could have gotten him low. Maybe Quifa could have gotten the attack afterwards, but yeah, this is...
Ooh. Oh! A nice job there, killing off the Shadow Demon, but unfortunately the Faceless Boy does go down, and the Earth Spirit doesn't have roll for 2 more seconds, but he's back under the tower. Battle Hunger, not enough. Yapso will be fine.
So, all things considered, that's really good for at least Kezu now. He's gonna have a better time of CSing. And he's gonna have two waves is the question. No, Puppy's gonna pull the next wave, unfortunately.
Yeah, but he'll still be able to hit level 3 off of this, and actually surprised in this type of lane, would you have recommended that he go for that auto?
Mid?
Okay, they are continuing to go on Timbersaw. They catch him this time. Yapso redeeming himself. This game is surprising. Maybe we have just been not having great luck here, but this one of the more action-packed ones we've gotten.
Yeah. Definitely this pure damage laser is a good counter to the Timbersaw, and it keeps right-clicking him over and over again. Koifa's doing a really good job of making sure he's like always at half HP, and then you have that bam, Yapsor showing up.
Oh, they're doing it again. They're just probably gonna put the harass out there, as you said. Tizzy getting down to half HP.
And at level 5 laser, or level 5? No, I'm pretty sure it's a level 3. So he's not maxing the march in this situation. So he's kind of like full battle tinker from the olden days right now. And this is very interesting. I kind of like it.
Yeah, we've seen actually a couple of people go for this type of build on Tinker. Certainly against the Timbersaw, it seems like something nice, especially if they're trying to shut down Arteezy. He's already picked up infused raindrops, though, realizing that Tinker wants his booty.
And he's also gotten 3 in reactive armor. Normally you don't see that. Normally you see from Arteezy 2-1-2 build, he can get in and out, but because of the amount of pressure is being put on him from this Tinker, and because of Koifa's amazing like build, because if he had just been greedy, like, oh, I'm just going to farm with March of the Machines, and he couldn't have harassed Timbersaw out of lane like this. Kudos to him.
Well, Bulba coming back up to top lane.
They missed the roll in the mid, but still,
will
they
be able to? They just get a good amount of damage out. I want to point out Bulba, level 1.
What?
You heard me, Bulba. Oh, he just hit level 2. I stand corrected.
So what happened is they blocked his camp earlier. I didn't mention this earlier. They blocked his camp there. It's the sentry ward is gone now.
Yep.
As everyone's saying. And then Puppy is jungling in his own jungle. So there's like no room for this Tidehunter, it felt like, for Bulba. And he didn't start off with the Iron Talon. He started with going to the offlane and try to get something, but couldn't because of this morphling.
Yeah, it just makes your life really hard if you're tied. And, well, hopefully someone will stack something for Bulba to catch up on. But at the same time, Puppy's farming really well. Perhaps, as you'd expect of a jungling axe, perhaps they can swap some of that, you know? Say, hey, Puppy, you take on some of the burden of initiation while Tide figures out getting a mech at 18 minutes.
That's going to be a very long time before they even think about what Bulba's going to have as an item.
Back to checking out this mid lane. I'm still really interested. Arteezy doing a good job of keeping up the CS. And actually, we're going to have a fight at the bottom room. It looks like Disruption coming out. Puppy getting ready for that call. He's going to go on to Koifa. They're not getting the spins, though. Envy's here as well. And Koifa surrounded by the enemies, blown up by the Mono Void. Oof.
That's just understanding. Like, that's a pro team understanding when and where to strike. Like, if they had... They knew that the rune was going to spawn. They knew Koifa was going to go to the bot lane. The problem was, Yapsor was really aware of having the situation where he was able to go mid lane.
Oh yeah, we're going to be seeing the action coming in.
It's Yapsor though. I heard the Faceless Void go in, but Kezu was just trying to get away from danger. I'm very curious to see where this gank's gonna go. Poor Bulba. Poor Bulba.
Poor Bulba. Oh, yeah. Bulba getting gone on. Brought down again. Koifa racking up another kill to his name.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Alright, boys. Get... Come on, Secret. You can do it.
Well, it's not like they're out of it. They're actually, of course, in the experience lead with puppy jungling. They're
no, they're
fine.
They're in a good situation in this game because Eternal Envy's free farming. It's just Bulba. I feel bad every time he dies. Like trying to get something done for his team, but it's just like level 3 at 8 minutes. This is like some TI3 shit where it's just like getting nothing.
On the upside, of course, as you said, Eternal Envy is free farming, and Era on a Morphling, you need a lot of items to get involved. You need, you know, AM can go for a build that lets him become active a little earlier.
I'm not sure if they want to go Vanguard. I think this is a free farm game. I do think Envy shouldn't go Vanguard if there's a game ever to do it, because this is a very passive game. And Envy just wants to soak up all the farm, where Secret, they want a four man constantly. And just protect Envy.
Now Koikva, he is in trouble again, throws out the mod, but there are a lot of heroes here. There was a silence of the puppy doing good work. He's now taking some tower damage. Koikva will go down, but they catch puppy as well. Tinker looking for the escape. There's going to be the roll on over. They manage to find Pylite. Diera gets the kill. And again, escape holding their own, a Secret.
Yeah, that's very unfortunate for Yapzor. He missed this kick. Koikva would have lived, potentially. Arteezy with that lucky S4 rune, though. Getting that kill, and that's what Arteezy really needed.
Yep. So, we're gonna be seeing a little lead there coming out for Escape. They're still behind in experience, but beginning to get that gold that they need, and Era working up on that Lincoln.
Let's see, what this is a pretty good and bad Lincoln's game. Like, it's amazing to counteract the anti-mage. It's also a great farming item. That's most of the reasons why a lot of times Morphlings have to go Lincoln's, just so you're constantly waveforming and split pushing around the map, because Botto and Aquila, sometimes it's not enough regen, and you have to go back to base a lot of the times, and it's not optimal farming if you're trying to, you know, out-carry. It's going to help out for the Mana Void, in most situations, but it's not going to help out versus the Axe or the Ravage.
Yeah, it's a rough one, because obviously it's kind of the Morphling build, but I don't disagree with you. There are less than optimal things here for it to block. So, Era, he's going to go for it anyway. That's them's the rules. He can start building up other things, deciding whether he wants to go shotgun or a different build later. Oh, there's going to be a disruption right here. Arteezy on top of poor Yapzor, and it's not looking great for him. He got himself a bounty rune, but he paid the price for it.
The price. I'm pretty sure it's worth it. It's like stealing that bounty rune from that alchemist, but there's no alchemist in this game. Sad times. Actually, good times. I don't want to see enough in this game. I take that back.
Not the most exciting always. No. Anyway, looking around, let's see what else other folks have gotten up. We got infused raindrops across the board. Always important to have those. Other than Era's progress, not seeing too much coming out here.
I would say the state of affairs of the game is benefiting kind of Escape more in the sense for their mid game, because they really want to make sure that Tinker has a nice time, and so far he has, in the sense where he almost has his boots of travel up, and then they can start making plays around the map. So they're trying to set up bottom lane on EE. Can they kill him?
They're looking for the Chronosphere. They need damage to output into there. Really interesting. They're going to probably throw out the silence here. Keep him in place. Do they have it? No, he manages to blink away. And unfortunately, do you think that could have turned out differently because we waited another second?
Yeah. You just needed to have Era there. Very unfortunate. They thought they had enough burst damage, and that kill is the biggest deal of this game if it comes around to bite them, because killing an anti-mage before his Battle Fury slows down his farm tremendously. Like, what should have now been a, like, you know, 13 minute or 14 minute Battle Fury could have turned into like a 17 or 18 minute. And when you have this acceleration of his farm, I just can't believe they messed up that gank there. It's very unfortunate. They're gonna have to suck it up, because you don't get that many opportunities. That's the problem with Antimage. He's like always around the map. You only have this Chrono to kill him, and you get one shot.
It's gonna be another 60 seconds before they can try for the chrono again. Radiant's and of course, Envy gonna be more cautious. So, we've also got a couple deep wards by secret, and they do have a ward behind the tower here. So, Eris should be able to get this push going, get it down, and that'll open up ganking the jungle again, trying to make Envy's life hard.
Yeah, they can invade the jungle, try to go around. So, all things considered, Escape here, they've done a really nice job of having map control, and with a Tinker, that's what you want. You don't want to lose towers, you want to hold them. Hey.
Oh, we've got Invisible Yapzor at the ready. Bulba is here, has the Ravage. Let's wait for Kazu. He doesn't have Chronosphere for 20 seconds. There's not a good... Yeah, there's not a great way for them to initiate without that, so it looks like they'll just march back on out the tower. Don't think it's so. May it get forced into deny range. Nope. Just off of deny range. All up. Oh, Koikfa standing right next to Pylai Dai. Does he know? Oh, they know now. Pylai Dai gonna start throwing out some shadow poison. AM's getting ready to come on over to Koikfa. He has to be careful here. He's got some support from Yapzor, and Eternal Envy will be silenced up there and blinded. Neither side can really kill each other. Oh, I'm still looking for Pylai Dai, but not gonna find him.
Yeah, I don't even have any more stuns to really cancel his TP either. So, just fishing in an empty pot. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. This is just gonna be a farm fest, guys. Popcorn, go get your wives, tell them a story.
Yeah, we're not at the really active start. We had to...
Yeah, it's about... gonna slow down eventually.
Yeah. We know what key items are gonna be coming out of folks. EE wanting that Battle Fury, or TZ, of course, wanting a Bloodstone. Era actually picks up the Dragon Lance before finishing this Lincoln's, if he is going to finish a Lincoln's, and bottom Kazu is looking like maybe getting ready to open up onto Bulba. If he's here, can he get in range to drop his toolkit?
Yeah, this should be a free kill onto the Tide.
Is this the time dilation coming out or the Chronosphere coming out this circle? Like what?
That's the time walk.
This is the time walk, end of the time walk, okay.
Yeah.
I've just never seen this frame.
It's true for a lot of us. I'm pretty sure he's gonna cast time dilation, so technically it could still be that, but I think it is the time walk in this case.
We're gonna be seeing that coming up soon. What? Got poking around. See if we got some fun items. I mean, not too much to expect. Puppy very close to the blink.
Fun item.
Yeah, do you smoke for that? I mean, they can for sure get a kill, I think. Blink reveal.
How far off is he?
Does he have 50.
Oh yeah, 50. Yep. Envy has his Battle Fury up too. So this is the time where you want to protect one. Probably after Bulba dies here, they'll start going as four and trying to acquire some map control.
Nope. Kazu with a little bit of the smack around, the time dilation does come out. Tinkle through the rockets, and they're not going for that kill. So.
Yeah, Tide's pretty beefy. I think if Koifa had a Blink Dagger, maybe they go for it, but I guess it's risky. Problem with Escape's lineup is they have no way to really burst people until they get either Shotgun and Era, maybe Koifa eventually having, you know, he'll probably still go the standard Aether Lens Ags, but they don't have that online, so they don't have that much burst right now.
Well, this should put the tower in eye range. Catapult, always a joke that way, so Bulba can help his team out there.
Kazu go!
Yeah, he's not thinking about it. He's Iron Talon jungling, having a blast. It really is just going to be a farm fest. How many items do we need up before that we actually see some action?
That's coming now. Here we come. Even Eternal Envy's coming to this.
Nope. They want to make sure they get him involved. This is the smoke gank we talked about with the blink, but it would just be a kill on Yapzor. That would secure them the tower. It feels like the ward being dropped there means that they can easily open up there. Look, there's the blink. There's the call, the spin. So, getting the kill.
Not much you can really do in that situation. And they're just gonna have to give up this tower top. Tinker is not really set up for this, and the only way he could realistically come into this, he would need a blink dagger, but if he does, then Timbersaw can just, you know, chakra him, clear out these trees. Not an ideal situation. Oba getting mana burned though in the mid lane.
Yeah, he is stuck in there, and now he's waveform Oba, and Bulba the Abbey Strike caught one hit coming out there by Kazu. He does not actually get the time dilation off onto Puppy. Eric continuing to hit him around, but this should be the mid tower. And for Escape, this is some really great map control they just got. They got the bottom tower, they're gonna get mid. This really opens up the secret jungle. We've got a disruption onto Era the Cold, but now Puppy, he needs to leave town. And again, this tower looking like it is well within the reach of Gabe.
Killing everything. So, still space for Envy. Space for Tinker now, too, and Era. So, this game is very interesting for me, at least. Like, you have two split pushers from Escape, and then the other side, you have kind of two. Like, Arteezy's really good at clearing creep waves and going around the map, but I just feel like Eternal Envy is like that main one. And later on in this game, which it's gonna go for a long time, guys, unless one team makes like a huge snub, but it's gonna come down to the initiations and then just trying to play keep away. Who's gonna play keep away the best and set up for the better team fights? But I think Secret have the best opportunity right now out of both teams, set up somewhere on the map. Like, you have the chrono for Kezu, but I think Secret, they just need to keep making that space as we keep talking about for EE.
Yeah, we've all seen EE farm up a storm before. He is just very efficient, and especially with Pilot, I really like this Secret positioning a support always behind EE to make sure that there's no danger coming to him. Even if he gets caught out here again by a silence, he'll be totally fine and able to disrupt EE, save his life.
They have so many saves in this game. It's just ridiculous. The problem is that we talked about it in the draft earlier, guys. For all those people that are tuning in, the problem now is that Shadow Priest, he's going to get countered. Whereas the Shadow Demon, like that disruption, nothing's going to go through it. Whereas we have the Axe Call coming for Puppy, so the saves aren't necessarily going to be there for the Dazzle at times. So they're going to have to realistically rely on maybe some good Chrono saves, some good kicks from Yapzor to really keep their heroes alive in these team fights.
And it's very difficult, I feel, for Escape to itemize around it. BKBs don't save you from everything here, since Cole goes through it, as does the Purge. And yes, you probably want one at some point because there is a lot of magic damage. You don't want to be stunned up by Ravage all the time. So, Escape, hard, to say the least. But they're still doing great. I'm actually really impressed so far. Secret has had a lot of other very dominant performance, although they have dropped two games throughout this open qualifier so far. TZ finishing up the Bloodstone there, and Tide has the mech, has the arcanes. So again, Secret hitting another power peak there for being ready to fight.
Yeah, the X factor probably that could be the biggest key for Secret winning this game could be this axe, where he's getting farm.
Huh? Okay, the Cole slightly off the mark, but it might not matter.
Kezu,
he manages to get the ulti off, but do they have the damage to punch into it? Kezu has the time walk away. Bulba, he's got a Ravage at the ready. Silence up here. Now just standing in the mod. Probably wants to wander on out of that. And despite dropping... Oh, they're still going for Arteezy. The missed roll in. Magnetize doing some good work, but not going to be enough, and everybody gets to walk away. A lot of folks ultiless.
Oh. It's just funny, this morphling this game, though. Like, he can still Axe Call. Oh.
Let's see. Okay, Era maybe not wanting to fight up against Tonal Envy himself. He's still going for it, Era. Oh, no, he didn't realize the Lincoln was done. And EE goes down.
Well.
Did he not?
Just an EE play, guys. No, he didn't. No, because
he didn't click on him. And meanwhile, in bottom lane, Bulba in a little bit of trouble too. They are trying to work on him. The Weave is out there. Get some more time locks. They don't need them. Koipa's here, bringing him down. And
Q God's back, boys. The old days.
Back. Era too. Yeah, I guess
these
E.
plays. I was just about to start talking about, like, this is a Morphling's, like, wet dream game for stealing enemy heroes. Like, you got Axe, his image that spins to win. You also have the Anti-Mage and his mana that we talked about a little bit in the draft, but not too much, considering that AM and Morphling were the last picks. But this opens up Roche now. So Escape doing a really good job here. But are they going to lose Coypha? Nope, they are not.
Yeah, and, well, okay, actually, they're taking a while. They managed to get this, the Aegis going out. Puppy, he is standing right next to Kezu, but obviously has a blink working on his blade mail, so making a lot of sense. I agree with you. We've already seen them use the AM illusion. That's how they caught out the Tide earlier.
Yep.
Drained his
during
mana.
The mid one, or yeah. tier one mid.
And, so far, Escape looking good. They are farming a little bit more slowly than Secret overall. They obviously got a big teamfight win there, but previously they had been letting the farm trend towards Secret. Hopefully they can keep it up on Era and Coypha and pull this one out. Already the Lincoln's paying off. Era has 3k gold on top of that Lincoln's all of a sudden. Guy has shot out to be 1,000 gold ahead of the AM.
Yeah, and this is a very questionable game of what you want to go for as a Morphling. You probably don't want to go E-Blade because it doesn't scale as well. And there's not that many prime targets to really blow up, but it's so good against Timbersaw.
Oh, Teezy, he gets stunned out before he can Timber Chain away. Now Silence, will they get in range to zap him down? He goes for the TP, but the Adaptive Strike follows him. Okay.
Man, Secret are just getting so greedy on the map. They're trying to, they have so many cores that need farm, and they're just like, just, Escape are just outplaying them. They're out map controlling them. They're going everywhere. And like you said, that Secret, that's their first Bloodstone kind of death there from Arteezy. So he's going to respawn really fast. He's going to come back now. Only 8 charges, though.
Believe folks saw each other. It is nighttime. Yeah, they saw each other. So, oh, okay, Era. He has no chill. Lincoln's will be popped, but look at it. How much damage he just did to EE there.
Oh, yeah. This is...
Now, normally I would be saying I would expect Era to come online a little bit later just because the Lincoln's doesn't always give you as much damage, and EE, with a Battle Fury, you farm up that Manta very fast, but... Era, with the good fight engagements, the fact that he has 3 kills, 206 creeps at 23 minutes, he's hitting like a truck. He already casually has the Eagle Song.
Yep. He should... I mean, this is a really good butterfly game, too, because Anti-Mage really doesn't want to go MKB. So, I'm going to be interested. Yeah, he's still going to go Shotgun. So, Shotgun's amazing versus a lot of these heroes in a sense where... can blow up the Timbersaw. I think that's the main reason he's going for it. And you saw how fast Envy does melt because he still doesn't have that Mantis style online. Now he has to be very careful when he's trying to go for Puppy. Puppy has the blade mail. He doesn't want to commit suicide there on the Morphling, but...
Oh, the Morphling gets him! Era with the shotgun reveal, blowing up Puppy, and that's an awful sign for them.
Yep,
if
nice
you can
segue
blow up the axe,
there.
Yeah.
It was just like, oh, Puppy, you have a chance to kill Era, but no. No.
He will motor you. And he can do it again in 3 more seconds. Arteezy, of course, a bit tankier, so. But, okay, he's gonna go for it anyway. Era just smacking Arteezy around. He just got him down to half health.
He should R, honestly.
Oh my goodness, it's the Silent onto Arteezy. Now he is stunned up. Will they be able to get it? They do stun him out. Arteezy in so much trouble. He suicides.
Crumbling.
What is happening here, Ryu? I'm gonna need you to break it down
Kezu.
In 4 words, because Kezu, oh, he walks right under a sentry, the rest of his team not quite there, but instead they run away and they leave Pylai die there. I definitely feel like Kezu shouldn't be getting this for free. In fact, he won't. The rocket's not gonna be good enough, but on the back line, this Era, he gets called up, and now look at who's overextending. He's morphing strength, though. He has waveform up. He's still going into this fight. He's just smacking away at Bulbur. Unfortunately, not a rocket as much damage, and didn't morph back all of the Agi before throwing out the shotgun.
I'm really surprised the Kraken didn't take off the E-Blade there immediately. That was kind of weird. Maybe he didn't. Yeah, well, he should have done enough damage. That was a huge chunk with the E-Blade, but nonetheless, this is...
Okay, break it down. What is happening? He obviously, it felt like there was some very greedy play coming out there by Secret, but the team
cohesion... Create space for Eternal Envy. That's how they play. They try to get as much as they can around the map for Secret, and then sometimes it just doesn't pay off. And Escape Gaming have done a really nice job. We didn't get to talk too much about the Shadow Blade either, but that's really nice for Kezu to go around the map, try and find these pickoffs. You also have Era playing out of his mind this game on a Morphling that this hero has a very, like, if you don't play it properly, you're just going to straight up lose. But Era's understand how to split push. He has the perfect heroes to replicate and play a very offensive game. So I really love what I'm seeing from this guy, and he's going to be going for a BKB. He's going to be man fighting. That's what they need to win these team fights. If he gets a BKB, they have no way to really stop him besides the axe call.
No, he has to wait 10 seconds here for his TP. Doesn't look like they know. Do you think Envy will be able to fight up against Era here?
When he has BKB, no. Morphling's going to win that fight 100% of the time. And the problem is...
Okay, he's going on to Pylite die. He needs another auto attack. A little bit of a misclick, though. Well, no. Okay. Era,
A ground. There
yes.
We go.
He gets it.
There you go. For all those 2K pubs out there, that is why you A ground. Don't right click up the hill. All right. Dota 101 with Newcaster. And there we go.
Okay, they are looking for Era. Maybe this time they can get him. They do manage to get the ult off, but Era somehow still not dead. And Tinker coming in with the cover fire. This is... Oh no, and the Chronosphere! Kazu's poking away at them. Yapzor, the Ravage comes out. Era is back in the fight. He needs some heals. Cinder and staying back, positioning perfectly to throw out the Shallow Grave if he needs to. Koikma ready to come on back in. Axe is down. There was an adaptive strike, and Bulba goes. Another win for Escape.
Yeah, I'm not... Ooh, they're doing it. They're actually doing it, guys. I think Secret... They've been on a massive losing streak. They're about to lose almost... I'm not saying they're out of it yet. Sorry. Just calm down. But you cannot help but get excited for this Escape Gaming team. They are just taking it to Secret right now, and they are just accumulating not a massive lead, but it just feels like they're getting in their heads. And when you're not scaling with this Timbersaw at all, it's like a useless hero. It's starting to feel like a useless hero right now for Arteezy. And when have we seen that? We haven't seen that at all this tournament, because Arteezy's just been able to do whatever he wants on this hero. But he's getting limited.
I don't know what to say. That's where we're standing on this one. I think most people were not expecting Escape to do particularly well. Imagine if you're the org that picked up Diggity. You're feeling pretty good right about now that you bet on the right horse.
Oh yeah.
Puppy! Getting blown up again by Era.
Can't blade mail what you can't see, guys. And that is... That's just painful to watch, because Puppy was supposed to be that extra, you know, factor. Like,
oh, Arteezy, what are you doing? He has silenced up. Can he escape? The silence won't be
suicide.
For that long. No, he goes down.
Suicide still on cooldown. 38 seconds. Bam.
Four Bloodstone charges. And yeah, that is... How many suicides does he use in this game? I think it was two already, but it might have just been the one. I could be crazy. My mind's being blown.
He's only used one suicide this game, but he's
died. Did you have to put a bet on that? Is that your compendium prediction?
I've gotten a lot wrong this time. You don't bet on Secret, that's
what. Apparently, you don't bet on Secret. Oh, and think of the bettors. Someone's going home, potentially, with huge all Bugattis.
Yeah, but they're still doing a really good job, and... They need to make sure they try and find a good teamfight for Secret next. Like, are they going to find somebody?
He is looking. That's going to be the Chronosphere coming out. He needs some backup. Where is the rest of his team in Kezu? Very
right,
ambitious
Kezu.
There. Kind of needed some help. He has a gem on him as well. If Kezu goes down here, this is a disaster for them. Syndrome doesn't get close enough in. Knows that the Shallow Grave will just be head chopped anyway. So he will just try to run it on out, and now it is Escape for Extend.
Yeah, those plays can't happen, because that opens up Secret to do Roach if it was up. It's up right now. They can potentially do Roach if they just go over there, and that could be... Secret aren't really down in this game at all. Oh, Dire Courier just got sniped by EEE. But
the other big thing, as you said, to mention is it's 30 minutes in. It is a 4K gold lead for Escape. no experience lead, that's not very much, right? The kills, they may be up some on escape, but if they're not careful, EE, as we're seeing, is farming very well. And even though they've kept Arteezy down some, eventually this Timbersaw will get some farm. But at the same time, Koikba, who we haven't checked in on in a while, has finished up the Aghanim Scepter, has finished up the Aether Lens, has got a good chunk of gold that may be turning into a sheepstick deal with some of the folks.
Yo.
Oh, Puppy going for the call onto Era. Koikba is right there, laser coming out. Puppy, he can't get the Duncan Era using that BKB. Will he be able to find anyone? No, he's just going to farm. Gold farming happens to the best of us.
He's the golden boy. He's chosen. Chosen to send Sindarin back to TI5, TI6.
Yes.
As a player.
I hear you got corrected on that one or something. About the TI Sindarin experience. No, but this is awesome. Like, guys, this is a great storyline. As we might like to joke, it's the Cinderella storyline. He's been out of the competitive scene for a while, able to come back in here. And they are just doing fantastically. They're gonna get themselves an Aegis. Regardless of whether they win or lose this on escape, it's gonna put you in damn high spirits that you're holding up with Secret, the team that was thought by everyone to kind of just playing these as a formality due to their roster shift.
Yeah, they're taking it to... I think everybody's just taking it to each other in this European qualifier, honestly.
We've got the damn good games.
Yeah, we're not in A anymore. And this is a very interesting topic to talk about right now for Faceless Void. He had went for the Shadowblade, but this is an amazing Silver Edge game. And normally you don't even think about it. It's like he wanted the Shadowblade just to set up for kills, but if he gets that Silver Edge, I realistically can see him killing somebody with one, plus one. You can take off so many things on Secret. You can take off everything from at least one of the heroes besides Shadow Demon. I'll let everybody in chat name them.
Exactly. No, I agree. And meanwhile, Era just ripping right on through towers. He's hitting like a truck. He's got bots casually stashed up. Did Koikva decide? No, he actually goes for a Bloodstone. It wasn't going to be a sheepstick out of him. He's saying, hey guys, we're the ones getting the kills. I'm going to kill Arteezy some more. Get me some charges.
The reason why you go Bloodstone first, and then you're going to go back for Sheepstick is because, you're going to scale better, you're going to get more kills with it, and it's more so you get more mana regen for these marches. And what he wants to do is, they want to siege the high ground and have Tinker go for like 4 or 5 marches. So that's what Escape want to do when they go high ground. But that Secret, are when they fight, they're fighting into like 5 marches and they're like, okay, how the hell do we fight? We're just going to take 3 wrecks for Escape Gaming. And that's their thought process right now when you go that Bloodstone.
Here's another thing. Obviously, the call's really nice here on the Axe because it doesn't care about Era's Lincolns and, you know, or the BKB and can hold him in place. Where's their Lincolns Breaker, though? Gush?
They've been using, Gush and Battle Hunger so far. You could also use Shadow Demon's Disruption, but that's very fun, or the Demonic Purge.
Yeah.
But it's not ideal to use the Purge, but it's still a good form of initiation, at least, so they can realistically lock Era down, because they're having problems with doing that.
Yeah, considering the situation, they do actually have good heroes on Secret for bringing this back. And Bulba, you know, it's been a while. He does have 4 deaths, but he's starting to get that farm up. He's got a blink, he's got the mech, he's got the boots, he's got the initiation tools to follow up. But I think a big thing here is just how can they make sure that they're, one, they got to continue keeping farm going on Arteezy. And right now, we've been seeing them do a lot of work to deal with Era. We haven't even talked about how do they deal with Koikva.
I think it's a better point to bring up how do they get into the back lines and start dealing with this Tinker. And right now it's not looking easy because Era's going to be that person that's always on the front lines. They're not going to play super over aggressive and they're just going to be like, please, everybody, come on me. Come on, Era. I'm here. I'm in the front lines. I'm a big bad Morphling with the Aegis. And I'm just waiting to see what Escape want to do. Like, they're in no hurry to go to the high ground just yet, but they can because they have the Aegis online, and I'm just waiting for them to, like, what's the call, Sindarin? What are you going to do now? Are you just going to try and outstarve your opponents? which they are starting to do. They are finally accumulating a lead. It's up to about almost 7.5. Not the biggest deal at 35 minutes in the game, though, but...
We can see that they have the whole map control, though, when we switch over to their vision versus what we've got here for Secret, so doing a nice job there, and as you said, it will just continue to increase if they maintain this map vision since they can bomb the jungle. But as you said, about breaking high ground now, and problematically, Aegis only around for like 50 more seconds, so this may not be the Roche for escape, but... They have heroes that are not afraid to scale, and Faceless Void going full utility. It's going to be Ag Scepter coming out for him.
Yeah, that's still good to have, because that's their only real team fight setup, is having this Kezu Faceless Void ulti. So I understand why he wants to go for this instead of going for the Silver Edge, but I was just getting so hyped up for him Silver Edging Artesian, and it's just like he melts. It's like, where's my reactive armor, guys?
I don't disagree that it's really good later, but yeah. I like the pickup for now. And also,
now,
slot
sure.
efficiency, right? All of that, it's a great pickup, and I don't doubt that they'll go for it. But for now, just really wanting to make sure that they frequently have that Chronosphere. Because already, Kezu, he'd been doing good work catching people out alone. Tinker being able to come in. So, oh, he's got a Dagon. Koifa. Gonna be fun. I actually normally, I don't know about you, but sometimes the Tinker games, they end up a bit static. You can argue that we're in a bit of a static phase right now, but definitely being a bit more exciting with the lasers bouncing around and how tense things are, and the idea of escape beating Secret.
It's actually a really cool game this time around, because both teams are like farming really fast around the map, so everyone has items now, and it's not like, oh, well, we had to wait 70 minutes in the game for, like, a Naga Siren to get farmed before we can do anything. No, both teams can do something now, and they're almost, like, five or six slotted at this stage of the game. Yeah, Koifa, all he needs is his Dagon 5, which is, what, 3,000 more gold? 3, 4, 8, and he just 5-slotted. Era here, he's already 5-slotted. He can get rid of his Dragonlance for the Aegis and then get another Moonshard. Bots, too. They're already maxed out, and it's only 37 minutes in the game. Really good Dota to watch, because you're going to be seeing some high-skill team fights, a lot of items.
Let me give you those GPM 700 on Era, 50 on Envy, got to pick it up, man. And Tinker sitting at 500. Even Arteezy, who we said had a hard game, sitting comfortably above 450. So, well, we will hopefully see someone make a move in a second here. Both teams, we got one smoke in stock for Secret. We got two in stock for Escape, so that could be what they decide to go for. Era's hanging out here. He, of course, does have a replicate active, so.
Yeah, need to be a little bit careful. Envy has the Abyssal, so he can jump in, Mana Void, and then Abyssal. And then his team could potentially catch up, and then he won't have any mana.
Yeah, Era just gonna wave form it out. He does have Yapzor nearby. Gonna relax. Didn't quite catch Roche respawn timer, so we'll take a look in a second here.
Envy's probably the strongest hero on the map right now. It's kind of hard to say who is because of how well Era's been playing, but one catch out from EE, and I feel like Koifa's dead. So he has to be very careful for escape, whereas Era, I want to see if he's able to man fight a Morpho. Ooh. Yeah, no axe call. Gonna
but still,
hit.
Era poked at that tower, what, 5 shots? Took out a third of its health.
And that's what we're probably going to be seeing in the next 5 minutes, poking and prodding this high ground if this Aegis is in the hands of Escape. So the question now is still on Secret. Like, do you want to smoke out of the base and try and risk not defending your high ground? And let's look at their side. Do they have any smokes right now? They just bought one, and they also have one on Pylite Die.
They also have two buybacks, one on the AM, one on Bulba. So Bulba's good and bad. It gives him the option of, hey, if the fight goes south and he's going to go down, he knows he can respawn and ravage for the defense, but I don't know if they... I don't know. Obviously, you don't want to be hoping to use your buyback. It's just nice to know you have it.
I like using my buyback.
Yeah, so that's
makes me
all your
stressed in my games.
Means you can buy stuff.
It basically means you die once and game's over too.
No, I sometimes like using your buyback is freeing though, because you used your buyback already, so you're like, I'm buying out.
This is my sweet release, guys, buying back.
You made a lot of jokes of, oh, okay. Here we go, Arteezy. Let's check out the vision. They think that they're up there. Arteezy's pinging. Oh gosh, they're looking for someone. They have to know that this is Roach. It was an incredibly short timer, and oh no. Okay, now we've got a fight on our hands. There's gonna be the smoke coming out. EE may just check in the Roche pit. They managed to scan it out on escape and secret. They head down. Everybody's pinging Roche on, but instead we're gonna see Era begin to poke away at that tower. And secret, if they don't respond, this could be a Rax. Is Roche worth a Rax at this point?
Probably not.
Okay.
Not at all.
Well, we've got Timbersaw coming back in. I'm not sure that Era has to worry too much about that. I spoke too soon. Era taking a lot of damage, just jumps on out.
Huh, doesn't have the waveform now to work with to go back into Roche and kill it.
Has to walk around the long way, and Secret, they are coming back. They know. Everybody knows what's going on here. Atonal Envy, he's going to try to rush on in. There's so much Monster of the Machines. Can he steal the Rose kill and all the Aegis? It's picked up by Morphling.
Jeez, though.
Daya get it.
Oh, he killed
and
the Dark.
Oh, he used his BKB already. He's running around, ripping on through onto Puppy with the Blade Mail there. Era putting himself up. Blinkens is top. Timbersaw going to jump on through.
Oh no, Koifa.
What is happening? He's been caught out of position here. At least a shallow grave is there. He's gonna try to TP out. Is he gonna make it? No, he can't. But Kezu is there, poking away at Arteezy. He's gonna get bashed up. He blows up. Buybacks all over the place.
Nice suicide, at least from Arteezy. Like you said, buybacks coming out from Faceless Void. Well, as
yeah, also
Mr.
the
Yapser.
Earth Spirit. Yeah. So, somewhat. I mean, almost not a victory because. No, I shouldn't say almost. Secret win that, I would argue, because the Roche is off the map.
I actually think it's a good win for Escape because they have. I think it's 70% favored now for Escape for the game because they have Aegis now on Morphling, they blew Tide Ravage, and they also have really fast because of the Bloodstone. So
I am an idiot. I thought for a second that Era actually went down to one life. I was distracted by Koikba stuck up there. So.
This is
totally good because they have it.
Yeah, this is looking really good for Escape to at least, you know, penetrate the base grid, and they should be able to get this bottom Rax. It's gonna be all on EE right here. EE-sama, please save Secret's hopes.
Okay, what does this perfect fight look like? How does EE have to get on out there?
Question here. They're gonna have to find ways to lock down Era, but it's not gonna be easy.
He still has that 9-second BKB. He's been doing a really good job of holding it, so is Era, arguably.
It's like, they have to lock down Era with the Axe Call and just focus the others in the back. Realistically, if they can get Kezu again, that's the perfect way. That's how they won the last team fight.
Arteezy, he's silenced the waveform forwards. The rockets are coming out. Bulba, you got stunned up here. He doesn't have Ravage. So Era, gonna start working onto that melee rack, poking away at it. It's halfway dead. And Era, he doesn't care about your Chakram. He's just gonna move up to the side. That's Rax. Who cares about the range? They're gonna finish it off anyway, but Escape. Pretty much a free Rax like you mentioned, and that's the base. It's been broken.
Yeah, now it becomes a little bit harder. It's a little bit harder because now you have to worry about the tier 3 tower and the Tide Ravage coming up soon. So this is going to be a lot better for Secret to hold this. There's a better chance.
They're still sticking around a little bit. Era, of course, has Aegis for another 2.5 minutes. And, well, that'll be that. I love this gold disparity, but poor Shadow Demon sitting around 4,000, then an Era up around 30,000, so you can just see in the items that there is a huge big difference.
Yep. Basically all Pylite Dye needs, though, is this Aether Lens at least. So you can see, I mean, this Shadow Poison range is ridiculous. Demonic Purge is pretty long. As long as he gets a good disruption save. Oh, he's gonna play aggressive here though.
Yeah, gonna just hurt up Era. There's the call. trying to pull him deeper into their face. He's at half health, lower than that even. The wave of Koifa Ravage in the back to pick off the Koifa, and Era getting lower and lower. He does, of course, still have the Aegis. There it goes. It'll get burned. Azu, he's trying to kill off Eternal Envy, but he's not doing any damage. Koifa, he is back
puppy.
In the frame. Era, he's trying to kill off Poppy. Then the wave bomb through gets it, but Koifa very low. Altizi going onto the backline. Koifa is dead for 74 seconds now. And Era, he is just desperately trying to pick up Bolt, but he'll get him. Now working onto Altizi, but how do you lock this guy in place? He's blowing him. Altizi actually going to jump on through, and Eternal Envy coming through again. His illusions are there. Kezu going invisible, and Era just wandering away. Hold.
And that was a dieback coming in from Koifa. That was just an amazing setup from Eternal Envy going on to the Tinker at the start of the fight. They blew Ravage for it as well. So they didn't even have the second Ravage during the second time around, and they still won that? That's pretty good, all things considered. And they were chronoed. A really good team fight coming in from Secret. Puppy doing some MVP calls there. Shot caller and the axe caller.
Just very good play all around. Secret not ready to go down without a fight. So let's see, what have we missed on new item pickups? Because I know there's some stuff. Koifa.
Butterfly. I'm sorry, Era got Butterfly,
but... He's finished up the level 5 Dagon. I do wonder about, you know, he's got a full charge Bloodstone.
You might sell it, or swap it out for a Sheep 6.
Okay, we're going on to Eternal Envy. Koifa is around, but again, do they have the damage in the Chronosphere? It's not looking like it. Eternal Envy does pop a BKB charge for that, though.
Yep, baited.
I don't know, I guess if it's...
No.
It's 60 seconds on the Chronosphere, so actually...
Yeah, it's... I mean, Eternal Envy really needs to have these BKB charges in the team fights. They could be just getting locked down, get lasers to the face, whatnot, and just the man fight against Era is going to be very tough for him. So.
And there's, of course, the added issue of Era, as you said, finishing up the Butterfly. Eternal Envy going to have trouble right-clicking him now. Although, Timbersaw in that last fight did a good amount of damage to Era.
It's really hard for them to kill Timbersaw in these team fights because... When you're Secret in this game, Pilot Die plays really well. You have him getting nice disruptions off, good kiting capabilities with the Shadow Demon, as well as the Axe. Puppy played it immaculately in the last team fight, where he's just getting these calls. It's Timbersaw is just able to run free. So with Arteezy running free in the team fights, as well as Eternal Envy, they're just dishing out so much physical and magical. I guess Timbersaw is more pure damage here, but
he's got a mixture.
Yeah, it's like two pure, one magic, but most of the chakrams, but, like...
And most of the whirling deaths, like, you position them to end up being pure, too, so...
I feel like whirling death's one of those things, like, let me take half your HP. Give me those
Can
stats.
Can I have it? Yep, that'll be how it goes for EE. He's still, I mean, he has almost 5,000 gold left over. We haven't touched on it, but of course, I... believe Koikva's the longest cooldown, yeah, since he most recently used his. Both the Earth Spirit and the Faceless Void will have their buybacks coming back up again soon. Time-wise, of course, Earth Spirit needs more gold.
It's looking still good for Secret in this game, all things considered, because, like you said, they didn't really have to do buybacks. Eternal Envy's going for that MKB right now, so they're going to have ways to deal with it gaming. And the Morphling. So I like Secret's chances at this game, but I also like, you know, Escape's chances. So this is still a very close game. I don't even think there's really an edge, even with this Rex down in the bottom lane, 50 minutes in. I don't think there's a clear advantage. The only advantage that's held in this game right now is the map control for Escape Gaming and the Roche. Because they're on Dire's side, and they're constantly pushing out all the lanes, the Morphling and the Tinker.
Yep. I think we're at the stage where you make two mistakes. Obviously, I say two because there's going to be buybacks up and you lose your base because everybody's really, really hard at pushing. The downside for Secret is there are tier 2s to go through, but I imagine they could definitely get through a tier 2 and a tier 3 in the death timers if they did manage to burn buybacks. So, but of course, that's a lot of ifs. Escape do have those outer towers still as a little bit of leverage. Is this... Looking almost like they wanted to smoke, but instead just gonna be grouping up together. staying very close, not wanting to get picked off at all. We do have a refresher up on Bulba.
It's gonna be good. But we've seen Bulba just blow up to this Morphling. Honestly, I think Morphling could almost one-shot him. I think it'll get him down to like 300 HP. Might need to have an additional one or two rockets coming in from Tinker, but if they hit the Chrono onto the Tidehunter, I think they'll win these team fights, depending on how well Pylite Dye disrupts. So, as we talked about in this game, there's so many save kills for both teams. It's gonna come down to that. Oh, it's just executing properly, but Secret, they are very scary right now.
Do you think this Shadow Demon has justified the first pick?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's first pick material, and a lot of games where you have just the need to save somebody important, like saving AM, saving Tinker, Timber. Setting up for the Axe Call plays this game. The synergy is just crazy. This hero hasn't received enough love. And
you're happy to see Shadow Demon getting some loving.
Yeah. So it's a dead support. Making resurgence. It's kind of like Bane. I think Bane's kind of like been pioneered by Eternal Envy.
Oh my goodness, they've caught him out. Koizma is here. Gonna start rearming. Can Aero help out? They bring him down. That's a dominating streak. He, of course, does have buyback. So it's not as if it's GG, but that is a huge kill there.
And Aero is 12 and. Oh! Godlike.
Just error thing.
Those player predictions, though. Who picked Eternal Envy? You were wrong.
Was it you? Did you pick Eternal Envy?
Yeah, I did. I'm so bad with myself right now. Error.
Oh, Yapsor, he's dewarding, but he may get gone on here. He's in a lot of trouble. And Arteezy will be silenced up here. We are lagging like mad. There's going to be a bullet roll up the top. Puppy coming in, trying to kill off the Dazzle. Manages to get it. And it looks like, folks, they'll chase after Kezu, but meanwhile, Era is pushing in the bottom lane. Folks need
lag,
to keep
please.
It back. What did you say?
The lag, please.
Oh, yeah.
Stop.
Okay, yeah. We're just a little bit of lag. Hopefully, guys, it's not hitting you guys on the stream, but I'm sure. Oh, gosh. They have managed to chronosphere Puppy up there, but Eternal Envy is on the case on top of Koizma, blows him up to top of Kezu's health. He manages to time walk it off. Era is here trying to come into fight. He almost blows up Bulba, but there it is. The Ravage comes out, and Era, in a lot of trouble, manages to get his BKB off, turning around, trying to fight up onto Eternal Envy, who's taking mass amounts of damage. Era, I'm just seeing white stuff flying everywhere due to this lag, but
that's
it
what
looks
she
like...
said. Okay, well. All right.
It's Bulba. That type of game, Tidehunter.
Bulba just got that
pulling
white stuff.
Down.
He likes it. You know Bulba likes it.
He's flexible, type, you know. Nice like that.
He goes both ways. I know him. This is just like what is this lag though? I'm like seeing freeze frame right now. I can't.
Hey,
I'm stuttering.
The game is too good.
I'm stuttering.
I'm sorry.
No, but seriously, that was amazing play coming in. Okay, so what could have turned to Kezu being the hero turned into kind of like Bulba being the hero, where he refreshed Ravage just as Kezu refreshed his Chrono, pop it on them. Bulba, though, with that extra 1 sec, extra 1 inch, going the distance.
Did you say extra 1 inch?
Yeah, he's one-upping everybody up on Escape Gaming.
That's not a phrase I've heard, but yeah.
Every centimeter counts.
Centimeters now. You were a.
I'm converting.
You're converting.
I don't want to be American anymore, so I'm going to the Euro.
The bands are too hard. Yeah.
Are we Celsius or Fahrenheit?
Yeah.
This game is getting very hot.
Oh yeah, it as Draco would say, it's getting hot in here.
It's getting hot in here.
I am unsure of exactly who is going to be coming out on top. It's still...
You know what's coming out on top is definitely this lag. Or I'm tilted now.
You're tilted.
I can't even not talk about the lag because I feel like this is even worse than China. I'm not even joking. All right, it's fine.
They clearly.
I'm done. All right.
Are you good? You calm?
Good.
It's EU's revenge. Okay, look, we may have a team fight that we have to call with the massive lag, but we're gonna do it. We'll split it between the two of us.
Oh, it's back. It's fine. No,
don't acknowledge it. We just gotta focus on the game. Kezu, let's talk about him some. He has a refresher up and an Aghanim Scepter. He's actually holding the Aegis here. What do you want to see him? Obviously, I know you want Silver Edge. I know that's what you want.
I think it might not matter as much anymore in this game. I think he still needs the Blink Dagger. He might even sell the Shadow Blade for it or just hold on to that last. But I think Blink Dagger is just so paramount on this hero. You need to have that additional Blink range. And you can have, you know, the cute plays, right? You have Blink, Shadow Blade potentially. You like get really close with Shadow Blade because if they don't have the gem, then you can't see you. And then all of a sudden you just blink in. And Blink is just instant, whereas Time Walk, you see that animation at times. That's why if somebody's really fast, if you have like a miracle player in there, that could just be game losing or game winning. Because if like EE, he Abyssal Blades him as he's Time Walking in or something, be a disaster.
They need everything, every little bit they can get, even though they have won the few engagements for Escape. Again, Seeker just need to win a couple of team fights, and they're often able to defend this high ground. The real question is for Escape, how do they get a pickoff here? How do they break that base? I'm not sure. Do you think they can do it without a pickup? Pickoff?
Well, you have to try, or you're just going to have to go for like 90 more minutes or something.
I mean, hey, at some point, if you wait 90 minutes, someone's making a mistake. Oh yeah, look at these launcher machines, they're in lines due to the lag! Oh yeah! That's how I like them. Oh, yours are in lines too. Excellent. Excellent.
There's just so many robots. Many.
That's how we like it. Okay, Puppy, chilling in the mid lane, just use the coal. It looks like Era playing around on the sidelines. They do throw an adaptive strike out onto Arteezy, which we see well after the fact. So, I like, normally if this game, if it weren't such a tense game, I would reconnect, but we can't hear Arteezy get silenced and stunned, but again, they just really can't jump in on that yet. Oh, it doesn't, they need to. Era dodges the call, poking away. Why don't, you reconnect.
I accidentally left the game. Well, good luck. You're gonna have to solo Kanji.
Thanks, right? Really carrying No Sleep Llama. So, Era, he does end up destroying that tower.
It didn't fix it.
That's okay.
Fine though. We got this.
We'll patchwork it together, guys. Technical issues be damned, Era. See, his Lincoln's has been popped. Has to be a little bit careful. His BKB only sitting on 6 seconds. Oh no, see, he gets the Bashful Pilot out, but there it is. Ravage number one. Where is Ravage number two? Era got his BKB off in between. His team is blown up. Puppy is blown up. They end up losing the Earth Spirit, but they don't care. And Arteezy, he is taking a beating here. And Tezu, kind of questionable to crap all your teammates, but it's whatever. They're going to be fine. They caught out Envy. He doesn't go down, but they have zoned him away. And this looking to be another rack. Timbersaw does end up buying back the ult coming out of Envy. It's
still
not quite enough. And Kezu, he still has the Aegis. He'll go down, I think. Oh yeah, lag showing him there. Era's taking the range drag. Era's gonna take a melee Rax. And oh, finally Glyph comes out. That's exciting. That's something there. It's
hold the line.
Really good for Escape. They lay down the mod. Kill off the Corian. No, it flies away with a full sheepstick on it. Arteezy's sheepstick on it, what he needs to deal with Era here, but Era, he is working towards Megas. He doesn't want just those crummy supers, he wants the Megas. He hexed up, gets brought down, he does it the buyback. This is just it.
That's
They've
it.
Done it.
It's it.
They're FGD.
Oh, how the mighty have fallen, everyone. 4-1 start after yesterday's performance from Secret. Everybody thought they were gods, and oh, how the mighty have fallen here. Now they've lost 3 straight games, maybe 4 even. We're gonna have to get our stats man in here or something. Where's Nahas? That guy's probably sleeping. What a bum. Oh yeah, he's,